time for his close-up.
Come on, let's go say hi.
Rachel, Kylie, and her roommate live in Richfield with their four-legged friend, Blue.
Can you sit?
Kylie rescued the four-year-old after fostering another dog last year, who she says spooked their mail carrier.
She did bark and kind of run up to the mailman a little bit. She wasn't going to do anything. I know that. He maybe didn't know that.
Because then, she says, he pepper-sprayed that foster dog, Luna.
It was all very fast, but yes, it was... I didn't like that.
To make sure it didn't happen again, Kylie moved her mailbox from the house to the street, which now has a new sticker alerting mail carriers she has a dog.
You know, I will say, obviously, if you don't know a dog, you don't know what it's capable of, so I can imagine that it can be a little nerve-wracking for some people.
The Postal Service launched the new sticker program in some cities across the metro after a rise in dog bites. It says 32 mail carriers have been bitten here so far this year, up from 19 all of last year.
You know, I know a lot of people got dogs last year, and they may have not been as well socialized because we couldn't socialize them. So I can imagine that that has affected the dog bites.
Besides orange, the yellow one cautions carriers there's a dog at the next house. Customers are supposed to be notified about the stickers, but these neighbors say they weren't.
At the end of the day, I just kind of wanted to make it a smoother process so I didn't have any issues, the mailman didn't have any issues.
To avoid future clashes between dog and carrier, some of these neighbors have opted out of the sticker and delivery altogether and instead are paying about $150 a year to pick up their mail instead at a P.O. box. In Richfield, Jennifer Hoff, Care 11 News.